We're going to take some questions now for David Tennant, but only if you're 12 or under.
Very good. So,
first of all, then, let's try... let's go to Nathan, who's 11. Good morning, Nathan.
Hello.
Hey, Nathan, how you doing?
I'm okay, you?
Yeah, very good. Where are you calling from, Nathan?
Seth from Walden in Essex.
Nice. And what age are you?
I'm 11.
Then you qualify for the under 12. Well done. What's your question?
Well, when I watched Doctor Who, when Christopher Eccleston regenerated into you...
Uh-huh.
Because you inspired me to be an actor, and I think you're the best doctor in the whole wide world, and you probably will be in future references.
Nathan, you're going to make me cry, Nathan.
Is there any advice, like, for being a great doctor in acting? Because I'd love to be the doctor.
Well, do you know, I was exactly like you when I was 11, and, I don't really know how I managed it, but it just sort of worked out. I guess you just got to work hard. Probably go to drama school. Would you like to do that?
Well, I'd go to drama after school.
That's brilliant. That's a really good place to start. And then maybe when you leave school, you could go to drama school for a couple of years.
Follow in your footsteps.
Oh, God bless you, Nathan. Well, good luck. Okay. That sounds like you've got all the right ideas.
Okay, thank you.
Hey, listen, Nathan, good luck, because David was just like you when you were 11, weren't you? You were watching Doctor Who as
exactly,
a kid.
Exactly the same, yeah.
Wicked.
All right, Nathan, great question. Thank you very much
I'm
for calling
I'm looking forward
in.
To the 14th Doctor, played by Nathan.
And Nathan, when you become the Doctor in a couple of years' time, then you can come in and do a couple of breakfast show like David's done, yeah, with me?
Yeah.
All right, top man, thanks. So, have a great weekend.
Didn't sound so enthusiastic about that.
No, he didn't, did he? No.
See you, Nathan.
Bye.
Not up for the interview, was it? let's try Jordan in Watford, who's 6. Let's see what Jordan's question is. Good morning, Jordan.
Good morning.
Hey, Jordan, you sound perky this morning.
Yeah, I'm going to school in a minute.
Okay.
Can I ask you a little question?
Yeah, please do, Jordan.
What was your favourite moment in Doctor Who?
My favourite moment? Do you know, there's one coming up on Sunday night in the Waters of Mars, 7 o'clock on Sunday, where
smooth.
There's a bit just after, I can't give too much away, but just after the big explosion... There's a big explosion, and just after that, something happens to the Doctor like we've never seen before. That's one of my favourite moments. There you go, Jordan. There's a little spoiler for you.
Can I have your autograph?
Can we sort that out?
Of course we can, Jordan.
Of course we can, Jordan.
Jordan, is he making out to you, mate?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'll get him to do that. You stay there, and we'll get your details. Okay. Have a nice day at school, Jordan.
Thank you.
Bye bye.
Imogen, good morning.
Hello.
Hello.
Hello!
Imogen!
Hello, this is Imogen and Isabel, like 11 and 8.
Hey, well, nice to speak to you both. Where are you calling from?
We're calling from Raynham.
Are you on your way to school?
Yeah.
Okay. Have you got a question?
Yeah. Who is your favourite companion and why?
I can't choose favourites. Can you imagine the trouble I'd get into? Imagine if I said one of them was my favourite, what would the others think?
I don't know.
Yeah, no, they're all my favourites. They're all my best friends.
Okay.
Who's your favourite?
Rose.
Rose, right. Yeah, she's great, but so is Martha
David,
and so is
David,
Donna.
David, listen, you know, if kids come in and they're kind enough to call up and ask a question, the least you can do is answer the question. Are you suddenly now a politician? You're leaving, it doesn't matter. Well, you'll be a millionaire in a year's time. Sort of tax exile over
listen,
there.
Listen, you've met Billy and Freema and Catherine. I'm not choosing between them.
No, you have to. We're not moving on until we've had a name.
I go. Switch over now to Hart for a lovely interview with David Tennant.
Imogen, do you want the answer to your question?
Yeah.
So we're all going to wait here until we have an answer.
My favourite assistant is Christian O'Connell.
No,
he presses the buttons
well. No. Flattery won't get this. Imogen, I bet you'd love to hear the answer from your favourite Doctor Who, wouldn't you?
Yeah.
Imogen, don't let him wind you up. I've given you my answer.
Don't let him try and dodge it, you know, Imogen.
I think, Imogen, Isabel, I've got to be in school now. Oh, have a lovely day at school, girls.
Imogen, stay there. Would you like me to try and get the answer out of David? Yeah. Who do you think
Imogen, whose side are you on?
Imogen, who do you think his favourite might be? I think it's Billy Piper's Rose.
Why? Because she came back.
She came back. David must have asked her.
Yeah, but see, at Christmas, Donna comes back. So that doesn't prove anything.
So is Billy's your favourite?
You are not going to get me to choose
look into my eyes. Tell me Billy isn't your favourite.
Billy, Catherine and Freema are my favourite equal.
No, look, get that camera. We're filming this. Put it on his face.
Yeah, filming this. They're trying to, honestly. You listen, girls, and I'm speaking to the three of you now. You know how much I love you. All three of you. Let's move on.
Very professional act. Very slick. Well dodged. Imogen, I'm sorry I couldn't get it out of him. I felt like I've let you down, but I think it's Billy Piper.
Okay, so do I.
Have a good day at school.
Too late, girls.
Don't listen to the nasty man. Who's next?
All right, let's go to the travel and we'll take some more of these questions. So we've got Katie, Oliver, Harrison, Alex and Justin and a little man in Sheffield. It just says little man in Sheffield on the line. There's a little man in Sheffield on the line. Here's Mag-